we have this agree disagree template added, and my question is actually based on this particular figure. Now, of course, I'm adding templates that would correspond to what kind of questions I would like to ask, and you can include templates depending on what you would like to do in your presentation. So if you see this, actually low variance and low bias is the thing that we would like to achieve. So a similar question I would like my students to answer, so that I know that have they understood the concept of bias and variance. So my question to them would be, low bias and low variance is the most desired, though it's very difficult to achieve. So low bias and low variance is the most desired, and the students would agree or disagree. This is a draggable slide, which means you will see a small dot, and the student would have to click on either agree or disagree. Some of these draggables and drawings are not available in the free version, but I'm working with a premium trial, which, as you can see here, there are 90 trial days left. So this is available, but some of the features are not available, but most of them which are available are what will satisfy our usage. Okay, so this slide is also ready. Let's move to the next slide. So here I am telling students about the trade-off between variance and bias, and this particular figure actually says a lot about that trade-off. Now I'm going to try to focus on this particular graph a lot, because it's very important that the student understands this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create some three questions based on this particular figure, for which I'm going to copy this thrice. So I'm going to just duplicate this particular slide, as I have thought of three things that I would like to show with this particular slide. So this is the first. Now first, this is the graph, and there is a very nice link that explains about this trade-off, and I want the students to refer to that particular link and then answer. So what I'm going to do now is, if you go back from the templates, so I'm going back from the templates, you see this particular section here, which talks about ask students a question. Now let's talk about this template. Here you are given the facility to create customized questions of your choice. So if you want to add a question which requires a text answer, you will use text. If you want it to be choice, so this is a choice question, so you can give a multiple choice question with this. If you give like a mathematical question and you know that a number will be an answer, then you choose number. Here, if you would like to give a website to the student that he or she can refer to, and then the question is based on that website, you can use this particular option. Draw is when you would want your student to draw something, draw a graph, draw an image, draw an ER diagram. So anything that relates to drawing is what is going to be through this. Draggable is a draggable slide. So here again, you will have a point or something of that sort that you would make the student drag to the appropriate point. So here you can actually make your own type of questions. So I'm going to show you two or three of these, how they work. So first, let's pick up the website option, because I would like my students to see a website when they refer to this particular graph. So I click on website and I click on next, and here I have to provide the URL of this website. So this is the website that I am referring to. And what I'm just going to do is I will paste the URL and click on update slide. So once I do this, this particular website will be embedded in this slide itself.